Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing a small haul slash swatch video. So I got some new acrylics, colored acrylics from Valentino Beauty Pure, and I also got some new gel polish colors from Luxe Polish. So I wanted to open them up on camera and then do some swatches. I'll make sure to leave a note on the screen so you can see which powder is which and which polish is which. If you don't catch it, and then I also leave it in the description below. But this is Soft Touch by Valentino Beauty Pure. It's like a milky white color. So this is kind of like random colors in the acrylics and gels. I just kind of wanted to fill out my collection with kind of staple colors that I didn't have. This is the crystal clear. I'm not going to be swatching it. I'll in a later video test it probably against my other clears to see the difference in clarity. But this is like a light yellow color. I wanted to do some like more summery slash spring colors because I kind of felt like that's what I was lacking in my collection a little more. There's also some colors that I tend to mix a lot when it comes to gel polish that I just thought I should just go ahead and buy the solid color instead of just mixing them, just to save products and for just ease of use and timing. So I do have some Valentino Beauty Pure acrylics already, and the reason I bought from them again is because I needed some more colored acrylics, and I like that they offer these really small size containers. I mean, there's plenty of product in them, and you can get tons of use out of them, especially if you're encapsulating your colored acrylics with clear. But there's other product brands, such as like Knot Polish. I also have some of their colored acrylics, and their sizes, they don't really offer like really small jars like Valentino does. I love Knot Polish acrylics as well. They're super buttery, super high quality. But sometimes I don't want to commit to buying a whole jar when I just want like a little bit of colors. Especially colors that I don't use like super duper often. But anyway, that's why I kind of went with Valentino Beauty Pure for this. I'm not like totally stuck on any brand. So if you have any recommendations for really great acrylic brands, I would love for you to leave me some recommendations in the comments. I don't know if Valentino Beauty Pure or Knot Polish is cruelty free. I know Young Nails is, and I like to use their products, and I know Luxe Polish is. They don't sell acrylics yet, at least. And I do tend to like to stick towards cruelty free brands, just it for all my beauty, cleaning, everything. So I would like to kind of stick towards that with nails as well. But I know that it's kind of hard sometimes to find. So if you have any really great cruelty-free acrylic nail brands, please leave me some recommendations. But anyway, I'm just gonna keep letting you watch me swatch these. I think there's only one more left to do. Alright, guys, now getting into the gel polish swatches. I wanted to kind of pair them with the like nude to pink colors, and then I have the brights together, and then just kind of a random mix at the end. Just so I could kind of see the difference in color between the different pinks and nudes. So this one is Au Naturel, I believe is how you say it. And for the purpose of this swatch video, I'm just going to be doing a single coat. I generally like to use two coats always, no matter the opacity, really. Luxe Polish's blackout is super duper black, and you honestly only need one coat. But I like to apply really thin coats and always do two, just to ensure that the curing process is solid, because you definitely don't want to apply a coat that's too thick and it not be fully cured. It also kind of gets a little bulky when you do that. But anyway, for the purpose of this video, I'm just doing a single coat. And for these last two swatches, I wanted to compare the Gel Art Pod in Blanc to Luxa Polish's White Out, the gel polish version of white. And you can see me mixing it up here. I probably should have mixed it up even more just because it was kind of separated in the little tub. And you'll see at the end, I mean, this one looks a little bit streakier, I think, just because of my application and the brush. Honestly, they look pretty similar to me. I wouldn't normally use this little art pod to polish a whole nail anyway, just because I already have the white out gel polish. I would just literally use this for nail art, but just for the purpose of like seeing the opacity and all that compared to each other, I wanted to swatch them together. But yeah, guys, that pretty much concludes this video. Let me know what you thought about this type of video in the comments down below. Make sure to like and share the video, subscribe to my channel, and follow me on Instagram. And make sure to browse Press On Nails at my Etsy shop. But I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.